Now let us look at question number 4 for UGC NIET July 2018 examination. And this question number 4 is very amazing question. As you can see, it's an amazing question. Generally students ask me, sir, why do I need to practice the previous year GATE questions, or why do I need to practice the previous year ISRO questions? Because this question is actually of GATE or ISRO level, and this is an answer to the students who feel that the question, if they are practicing their questions related to the GATE examinations, then that is not very beneficial for them. This question absolutely tests your knowledge regarding the little Endian mechanism and regarding the concepts of C programming. And I can guarantee that 99% students who attempted this question, only 1% students gave the answer correctly for this given question. And let me explain you how this question is working. What is the output of the C program assuming little Endian representation of multi-byte data in which least significant bit is stored at the lowest memory address? Now to solve this question, the first concept that you know it, what is the difference between the little Endian mechanism, the little Endian mechanism, and the big Endian mechanism, big Endian mechanism. Now we studied this little Endian mechanism, big Endian mechanism in our computer architecture videos. If you remember, in computer architecture, when I was giving you the memory configuration, how the memory is configured, there I explained that we have two kinds of mechanism. One is the little Endian mechanism and second one is the big Endian mechanism. Okay. Now this question is totally based on little Endian and big Endian mechanism. At the same time, you should know how union is working or how the unions are created, and what is the difference between the union and what is the difference between the structure, right? For example, if I say we have a struct saving instead of union, here they are giving us a union instead of union. If we have struct saving and we have short int 1 and we have character 2, okay, if instead of union it was a structure, now the size of this variable, if I create a variable of this type, that is struct saving s, if we create a variable of this type which is struct saving, the size of this variable will be of 4 bytes. Why? Because 2 bytes are here and we have 2 bytes are here, total the size will be 4 bytes. But in case of union, the total size will be dependent on the memory, maximum memory which is allocated to a variable, right? For example, here the maximum memory is of 2 bytes. Here it also we are allocating 2 bytes of memory. Here also we are allocating 2 bytes of memory. So total memory that will be allocated to this union is of 2 bytes. First of all, you understand this concept. Okay. Now, we are creating a variable m of this union type. Let me take one more page and let me show it to you how this is working. And I can guarantee 99% of the students gave a wrong answer for this question number 4. It was a pretty amazing question, pretty easy and in-depth question for in-depth understanding. See, the program execution will start from the main function. Then we have a union saving which is having short int 1 and character 2. Then we created a variable of type union saving. Okay, so there is a variable m, and here in m we are storing the this values in index location 0, index location 1 of this character type. Now remember, here they have tested that if you can see m of 2 at index location 0, it is not in single inverted commas, because if this 5 is in single inverted commas, that means 5 must be a character. Okay, but here because this 5 is not in single inverted commas, that means it is a numeric value or number. Okay, so what is the binary equivalent of 5? That will be 00000101. So this is representing the binary equivalent of 5. In the same way, at the first index location they are storing 2, and for 2, what is the binary equivalent of 2? That will be 00000010. So this is representing the binary number for 2. Okay, now we are using percentage D here. As you can see, we are using percentage D and we are trying to print for the character. Now remember that when this memory will be allocated here, so here in the in this array we'll be having this array which is of 2. In this array, at the 0th index location we are storing the value 5, at the first index location we are storing the value which is 2, correct? If you just see the same value in terms of binary format, how this will be looking, it will be looking something like this. that 5 is storing here. 5 means 0000 0101, and 2 is stored here, which is 0000 0010. Okay, so it is representing index location 0, index location 1, correct? Now, assuming the address of this location is 1000, address of this location will be 1001 in case of arrays, correct? Now, we are printing m.2 at index location 0 with percentage d. If you are printing with percentage d, that means it is just going to print this decimal value. So, it will print 5, okay, right? Because this 5 is not in inverted commas. Remember, if instead of percentage d, if we could have used percentage c, then the answer will be different. But because they used percentage d, that means we are just printing the integer value here. So it will be 5, okay, which is stored here. Now, with m.2 with index location 1 and the index location 1, we are storing the value 2. These two things are correct. Now they are printing m.1. Okay, now this is the total memory that is allocated, and we are printing m.1 for. If you want to know what is the output of m.1, for that you should know what is the concept of this little Endian mechanism. It is saying the least significant byte is stored in the lowest memory. The least significant byte is stored at the lowest memory address. Lowest memory address will be storing the least significant byte, and the most significant byte here will be stored at the higher memory address. Okay, now look at this one and check again. You tell me, which of the following will it be the least significant byte, or will it be the least significant byte in case of little Endian mechanism? Little Endian mechanism, which one of them will be the least significant byte? Just check it out. If you see here, in case of little Endian mechanism, out of both of these two bytes, they are saying that least significant byte is stored in the lowest memory. And out of these two, this is the lowest memory. This is the lowest memory address, and this is denoting the highest memory address. Okay. Now here, because it is the lowest memory address, so least significant byte will be stored here. And because it is the highest memory address, so most significant byte will be stored here. So if you represent it for the calculation purposes only, so it will be represented like this: 0000 0010, because it is the most significant byte, and this will be stored here, which is 0000 0101. So this is the least significant byte. Okay, now evaluate this value. This entire value. Okay, so this is denoting 2 raised to power 0. This is denoting 2 raised to power 1. This is denoting 2 raised to power 2. This is denoting 2 raised to power 7. This is denoting 2 raised to power 8. This is denoting 2 raised to power 9. So the total will be 2 raised to power 9 plus 2 raised to power 2 plus 2 raised to power 0, which is denoting 517. So this is 2 raised to power 9 is 512. 2 raised to power 2 is 4, and 2 raised to power 0 is 1. So it is 512 plus 4 plus 1, which is denoting 517. So the correct answer to this given question here, the correct answer will be option number 4, which is 5, 2, 517. Okay, I can guarantee that 90% of the students who felt that they are only going to practice easier questions, they can easily crack the examination. For cracking this examination, definitely you need in-depth understanding of every question, which is absolutely necessary. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Now let us look at the question number 4 in the next video. Thank you so much.